Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today I wanted to share a braided updo. I ended up doing a ponytail first and then turning it into an updo. So let me know in the comment section which version you like better, the ponytail or the updo. If you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed yet, make sure to click that subscribe button. Click that bell as well, then you'll never miss any future videos. And let's get started. I'm going to begin these styles by creating the two French braids first. Since they're both on one side of my head, I'm going to part my hair in a deep side part on the right side, so I have a lot of hair to work with. With the hair divided out, I'm going to split this front section into two smaller sections, so I have two for each braid that I'll be creating. I'm going to clip off the forward section and create the second back braid first. I'm going to pick up a small section next to the part line to begin my braid, and I'm dividing this section into three smaller pieces. So I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand to begin the French braid. And I'm going to be incorporating new sections into the braid. Each time I cross a side strand over the middle strand, I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from my head, following along the braid, and cross it over the middle strand as well, incorporating it into the braid. So I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over into the middle strand as well. Then I'm crossing the other side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. I'm going to create the French braid along this side of my head. And as I'm bringing in new sections of hair, I want to make sure I'm only picking up pieces from this small section of hair that I've divided out and designated for this particular braid. Since I'm creating two French braids on this same side of my head, I want to make sure I have enough hair for both braids. Once the braid reaches my ear, I'm going to stop incorporating hair into the braid and continue braiding the section down to the ends. This will help ensure the braid lays smoothly against my head at this point. You can continually lay the braid against your head if you're unsure where to stop adding in new sections of hair. You'll want to see how it lays and just pay attention to any bumps that are formed once it's laid against the head in the direction of the back of the head, since this is where it'll be pinned in place. Once the braid reaches the ends, I'm going to slip some pins over the bottom so it doesn't unravel, and then go back over the braid and kind of loosen the backside to soften the style a little bit. Then I can move on to the next braid. So for the second braid, I'm going to create this with the remaining front section of hair that I had previously divided out. I'm going to pick up a small piece near the part and divide it into three smaller sections again. Since I'm braiding this hair into a French braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands over the middle strand while also bringing new sections of hair into the braid from along this section. I'm going to continue the French braid down this side of my head, bringing in new pieces as I go until the braid reaches my left ear. So I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over into the middle strand as well. Then I'm crossing the other side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. I'm going to create the French braid along this side of my head, and as I'm bringing in new sections of hair, I want to make sure I'm only picking up pieces from this small section of hair that I've divided out and designated for this particular braid. Once the braid reaches my ear, I'm going to stop incorporating hair into the braid and continue braiding the section down to the ends. So I'm still crossing the side strands over the middle strand and just working my way down to the bottom. Then I can slip some bobby pins over the end of the braid to ensure it doesn't unravel while I work on the rest of the hairstyle. So now I'm going to combine the remaining hair together into a low ponytail, leaving out the braids. I'm going to start by brushing all of the hair together, and once all of the hair going into the ponytail is smoothed down, I'm going to take my hairband and tie the hair off, creating a ponytail. You can make this as high or as low as you'd like. I knew mine would be a little lower, So I created the braids to line up with the ponytail. And once it's all tied off, I'm going to take both of my braids and bring them around to the back of my head and then wrap them over the ponytail. Now I'm going to take my topsy-tail tool. I got this from Amazon. And I'm going to slide it through the hairband and then wrap the ends of the braid through the loop at the top. Then when I pull the tail down through the ponytail, it'll pull the end of the braid underneath the hairband, so it'll hold it in place without needing to pin it or use another elastic. This didn't quite cover the hairband, so now I'm going to divide off a small section from the ponytail and use this to hide the hairband as well. So following the same steps as before, I'm going to slide the topsy-tail tool down through the hairband and then wrap the piece of hair around the hairband. Then I'm going to bring the ends through the loop at the top of the tool and then pull the tool down through the hairband, pulling the end of the wrapped piece as well. And this will hold it in place, keeping it wrapped around the hairband. Now I can go back over the hairstyle and kind of detail it. I'm going to pinch and pull on the hair at my crown to add a little bit of dimension and volume. Then I'm going to use a little bit of hairspray to smooth down any loose hairs and finish the style. Now to transition this ponytail into an updo, I'm going to share a really easy trick to help secure the bun in place so it stays all day. I'm going to take my ponytail and divide off a section of hair. So with the first section of the ponytail, I'm going to tie an elastic band about 3 to 4 inches down from the top of the ponytail. I'm going to create a gap in the hair right above the elastic and then flip the ends through the gap to create a topsy tail. Now I'm going to loop the topsy tail up towards my head so the elastic is right above the top of the ponytail. And then using some bobby pins, I'm going to pin the hair in place to begin forming the bun. Now I'm going to separate off another section from the ponytail. I'm going to tie another elastic band about 3 to 4 inches down the section of hair. Then I'm going to create a gap in the hair above the elastic. Flip the ends through the gap so the two side sections are twisted. And I'm going to bring the elastic band up to the top of the ponytail again, next to the previously pinned section. And I'm going to use some bobby pins to pin it in place. I ended up dividing my ponytail into 3 sections to create the bun. So if you want to follow suit, this will help give you an idea of how thick to make each section, since you'll want them to be about the same size. Now I'm going to take these shorter ends that are sticking out from the 2 pinned sections, and I'm going to combine them together and repeat the same process as before. So I'm wrapping a clear elastic band over the hair a few inches down. I'm going to create a gap above the elastic and flip the ends through the gap so the 2 sections are twisted. I'm going to take this new section and wrap this underneath the bun towards the left side. Then I'm going to tuck the elastic band under and pin the sections against my head on the left side of the bun using bobby pins. Now I'm going to take the remaining section of hair that's left down from the ponytail and repeat the same steps. So I'm tying an elastic band over the section of hair, creating a gap above the elastic, and then flipping the ends through the gap so the 2 side sections are twisted. I'm going to take this section and bring it up towards the top of the bun. So I went ahead and pinned that section in place at the top of the bun. And then I'm going to take care of the ends. So I'm wrapping another elastic over the section, creating a gap above the section again, and then flipping the ends around so the 2 side sections are twisted, creating another topsy tail. I'm going to fold this section down towards the top of the bun. This will fill in any gaps at the top, and I'm going to pin it in place with some more bobby pins. Once that's pinned, I'm going to take any ends that are left sticking out. I had a few at the very bottom of the bun, and I just went ahead and tucked them underneath the bun and then pinned them in place with bobby pins. I love the way this bun turned out, so be sure to let me know what you think about this down below in the comments.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video.
Make sure to comment down below which version you liked better, the ponytail or the updo. I don't know which one I like better. I really like both a whole lot. So make sure to click that thumbs up if you enjoyed this type of hairstyle. Click the thumbs down if you didn't. Either way, it helps me out. Be sure to subscribe and click that notification bell as always, and I will see you next time.